Hello students, this is Divya from bankexamstoday.com. Today I will be sharing some tips and do's and don'ts regarding the essay writing, which will be helpful for your exams. Okay students, so let's see what is the essay writing. First of all, essay, as you all know, is a formal way of writing. And it is the shorter form of the paragraph where you will be given a long paragraph in which you will have to read it carefully and then give the concise form of the same very paragraph. So it is basically the gist of the passage which is given to us and which we express in some few words. Okay, so a big paragraph has to be written concisely here. And where we cannot miss out the important details, we have to mention all the necessary details and make sure that the idea expressed in the passage is only written in the this essay writing, in the essay that we will be forming. So it should cover all the essential points and main theme should be there. It should not be something that is away from the topic. Okay, so don't miss out the main theme in that. What this is, what the essay writing is. So it is many students will be thinking it is like paraphrasing, but students, it is different from paraphrasing. Like a paraphrasing is what we do, the longer it is, sometimes longer than the original paragraph that is given to us, it has all the details. But in essay writing, it should be shorter than the original paragraph that is given to us and should only express the main theme, and also should we have to make sure that the main essence of the paragraph is written in the shorter format, that is our essay, right? So this is what the essay writing is. So now let's see what are the general guidelines or the rules that are to be followed for the essay writing. So students, first of all, what you need to do is, whatever the passage that is given to you, you have to attentively read that passage and then identify what the central idea, what actually the passage has is saying. What is the central idea behind it? So take that, identify the central idea out of the given passage. And then also, after reading it, you can also note it down, whatever the necessary details you find out, whatever the facts are there. So you can note it down, and so that it can be used in while writing the essay. Okay. So next is, what you can do is, as we all know that while writing a essay, word limit, it should be shorter than the original passage, right? So a word limit is a constraint here. So we have to express in few words whatever that is there in the given passage. So you have to identify the total number of words that is in the passage which is given. According, we can approximately find out, you can just count down the words in the one paragraph and then approximately figure, you'll come out with that. So what you can do is, and then the one third of that words, you, it can be used generally for the essay writing. So look out the number of the words, which is very important, right? So next is, when you are reading the passage, you just read it carefully, give it a couple of reads, and then start writing the essay. Okay, give it the proper reading, proper understanding should be there, and the central idea has to be identified, and then start reading the writing the essay. Okay. Also, you can what you can do is, you can highlight the most important points as you feel in whatever the important points are there in the passage. You can make note of that, and whatever the unnecessary details are there, leave those unnecessary details. Okay, So, and then it is important to give an apt heading to your press, which is important. So that heading you can only give after reading the your this paragraph which is given. Okay, and also you can follow the three grammatical rules while writing the press, which is first of all you have to write it in indirect form, and it means that you don't have to directly refer to something. Indirectly you will write it, and then in past tense if you are mentioning if you are writing something about history, and in third person as we all know you have to write like the point of view of the person being talked about, like what is the third person, like for example he, him, their, themselves, like that. Okay, so and then once you are done with the reading of the passage or the notes, whatever the notes you have drafted, review those notes once so that you can remove like the unnecessary chunk of out of it. And just also some errors, if you have done some errors you can remove that as well here. And then what just then again what you do, quickly overview the passage to make sure that anything is not missed from the main passage, okay, before writing the press, because the main details has to be covered for the press writing, right? Lastly, after writing the essay, you make sure to revise it so that there is whatever the errors might be there, you can correct it or add something if something is left. Okay, so that's all about the rules or the general guidelines for writing a press. Next is what you can do, some do's of the press writing. Like first of all, start the press with the key on main idea, so that once you've started writing the press, you what you do is start with the main idea, so that whoever the person is reading, the reader gets to know the essence of that press, whatever that is written in the original paragraph. Okay. And then write all the necessary points that I have already told. What you can do is you can write whatever the necessary points that you want to include in your press, and then use it for writing it. Okay. And then the main idea, whatever the main idea you have developed, you can start writing it in your own words, but that own word should not be should not be based on your opinion or something, but should focus on the main idea that is in their given paragraph, that is given in the paragraph. The paragraph which is given to us should focus on everything written should focus on the main idea. Okay. And then just the main essence should be written in one single small paragraph. This is very important that we have to write the main essence in one paragraph. Okay, and it should be like written precisely and should not miss out something which is necessary to be written. Okay. Then this don't you should not write anything which is not included in the original paragraph. It should be the part of don'ts. Okay, and then the logics, the statements, whatever should match with the written paragraph which is written. Okay, and like whatever the press you are writing should be in a logical order. You should know whatever that you are writing and should make some flow and should be well knitted. Okay. And should connect to the paragraph. Like the lines should be in flow and it's not like it's breaking somewhere like that. So what you need to do is it should be in a logical order, and the reader is able to understand what you are trying to say. Okay. And then you should also not change the author's voice or opinion. Whatever that is, the tone of the author is there in the given paragraph, the paragraph given. So you have to retain that. Okay. You cannot give your viewpoints or your opinions there. Write down, stick to the paragraph given or whatever that is written in the paragraph that is given. Okay. So next is a length should be kept in mind because whatever the data is given, okay, make sure that all the keywords are used properly and the concept is clear and length is appropriate. Okay, the core idea should be there and irrelevant data should not be included. Okay, and also write the purpose in the presse. While writing the presse, you should write the purpose of the presse writing, the presse that you've written. That will help the reader to understand the purpose of the presse. Okay. Next are the don'ts of the presse writing. So what are the don'ts, the things that you should not do while writing the presse? So you don't form your own opinions. Even if once you have read and understood the paragraph that is given, okay, don't form your own opinions. So what does this do? When you form your own opinions, you end up writing that only instead of giving the importance to what is written in the original paragraph, right? So don't form any of your opinions. Stick to whatever whatever that is written in the paragraph given, okay? And write your own remark, and sorry, do not write your own remarks, comments or criticism, anything, your viewpoint should not be there, your remarks or comments, criticism, nothing should be there in the presse writing. Just stick to the original paragraph given, okay? Also, whatever the facts and data should not be out of the information that is given in the original passage. For example, some topic comes and then you know some fact or data about that. You will not include that in your presse writing and just stick to whatever that is written in the original passage in the first place. Okay. And then you are not supposed to ask any question in the presse writing. If there has to be that question, just use the statement form of that question in the presse writing and don't ask a question, okay? And avoid, this is important, people use abbreviations and contractions in the presse writing. Avoid using that. Okay, the marks will be deducted if you'll be using the abbreviations, okay, for the words. So avoid using that. And one should not add one's objective interpretation. Don't interpret whatever that written in the original paragraph, or don't comment anything about that. Okay, and should just write it in the main idea has to be written, just that, okay? And no opinion should be expressed, anything like that, and it should be in a flow and should not be jerky, the break should not be there, should be in flow, whatever the key facts that you are stating from the paragraph. And the most important, do not copy the lines from the original paragraph. It is most important thing that students make mistakes here. They copy the lines from the paragraph, which is not to be done, and that whatever that has to be written in the presse, you have to interpret not in your own words, just state the that restate it, okay, and then write. Do not copy the lines. So here are some important tips that might help while writing the presse. First of all, choose your words carefully. Like whatever the words that you're choosing, make sure the words are not losing the essence that you want to want reader to know. And it should be the sense should not be missed out. And whatever that you want to convey should be you are able to convey that, okay? And construct your sentences in logical and concise manner. Obviously, presse writing is to write precisely. So your sentences has to be in a way so that you are making sense and writing concisely, obviously. And then if once you are shifting from one point to another, you shift in a smooth manner and there should be no jerk in there. and should makes you should make sense with your pressy and the whatever the logic that you wanted. It should be logical, right? And there should not be a mere selection of few important sentences. It pressy writing doesn't mean just from the given passage just select the two main lines that are the essence. It doesn't mean that. It means the collection of the disconnected facts, whatever the facts that are written in above, below, whatever. So with the proper usage of words or vocabulary or words, what you do is you make a state or reframe the sentence and then write a presse from the passage, okay? And there are no rigid rules regarding the length of presse, but generally whatever the passage is, original passage is given, one third of it, the total number of words should be one third of the original passage, the number of words in the original passage, okay? And then you should also retain the mood and tone of the author that is there in the presse. And unnecessary long sentences or thoughts are not required in the presse writing. Keep this in mind. Okay. So long sentences, avoid that. Okay. So that's all about the presse. And I hope you understood whatever is being taught. And also at a bank exams today, we are starting this descriptive paper evaluation service where our team of experts will be evaluating your essays, reading comprehensions, your presses, and video lectures are also there. So you can enroll for it. And for enrolling, you can go to learn.bankexamtoday.com or you can install Bank Exam Today mobile application. All the links are available in the description box below, so you can check that out. And if you have not liked the video, you can like it and subscribe to the channel. That's all for today. Thank you very much for watching. Bye bye.